Good morning, church!
Mayang buntag sa tanan.
It's good to be in the presence of the Lord in this house. Amen? Kindly greet the person next to you, please. Tell them, I am blessed to see you this morning.
I'm blessed to see you this morning.
I know, as we begin, I also would like to greet all our viewers who are watching on our church online. I hope that you are blessed in all parts of the country and all parts of the world. And before we begin, I'd like to start off with a prayer as we start. And I'd like to call my son, Mr. Chad Edgar Bantigi. Please come. Ninong kuno siya, when he grows up, he wants to be a pastor. Amen. Can you open us in prayers?
Okay, let's pray. Lord, thank you for this day you give the message to us, Lord. Thank you for the wonderful day you are giving us, Lord. We will open our hearts, Lord, to receive that message, Lord, today, Lord. Thank you for everything, Lord. Thank you for this church, the blessed church, Lord. Thank you for everything that you bless us. Jesus,
we
pray, amen.
Amen. Let's give God the glory. Amen. Thank you, now. You know, the world on April 1 celebrates April Fool's Day. We sometimes wonder why would we celebrate fooling people, or mangilad og tao, or pretend that you have something that you don't. Now today, anak, in a worldly sense, that there is an April Fool's Day. Magtingala ko sa akong Facebook feed na nainangaminyo, nainangamaligyag balay, nainangamaligyag mga bisan unsa na lang. Nya, atik ra dito. Kaya bigyan mong atik ra, no? But let us not be fooled by not knowing our security in Jesus Christ. If the world celebrates April Fool's Day, let us dilita magpailan in our security in Jesus Christ. Yes. Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
Amen. Now, church, last night there was a heavy rainfall. Grabe ka kusog sa ulan, and nindot ang atong mga tulog. But like all problems, there's sunshine in the morning. I know a lot of us are filled with burdens. Some of us are stressed. Some are looking at our financial responsibilities. And it has caused us a lot of burden in our hearts. But like every morning, there is hope. You know why I can say that? Because there is no assurance that there will be the next day. But we always set an alarm to wake up the following morning. That's hope and faith. So we're hopeful and we have faith that we will wake up in the morning. And because you are alive today, we must all be thankful to the Lord that He has given us life
to
move forward. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Now I'll be talking on one as much as possible due to the time constraint. I'll just be focusing in just five verses, and you can find this in Romans chapter 8, verses 5 to 10. And I will read it, and you can follow along with me. Romans chapter 8, verses 5 to 10, and it says, those who live according to the flesh have their mind set on what the flesh desires. But those who live in accordance with the Spirit have their mind set on the Spirit desires. Verse 6, the mind governed by the flesh is death. But the mind governed by the Spirit is life and peace. Verse 7, the mind governed by the flesh is hostile to God. It does not submit to God's law, nor can it do so. Hallelujah. Those who are in the realm of the flesh cannot please God. Verse 9, you, however, are not in the realm of the flesh, but in the realm of the Spirit. If indeed the Spirit of God lives in you, and if anyone does not have the Spirit of Christ, they do not belong to Christ. But the last verse, and not the least, but if Christ is in you, then even though your body is subject to death because of sin, the Spirit gives life because of righteousness.
Wow.
For the Lord has blessed His word this morning. We live our life thinking that we are secure because of the wealth that we have garnered through the years. We are secured in a sense that we have attained what anyone dreams of attaining. And just to wake up one morning, we have just lost it. And that feeling of losing something valuable is a regret that cannot ever be repaid. Do you agree? The guilt and regrets are things that cannot be rewinded. Our mind is very wonderful. We have a brain that is capable of making, doing, creating things that only are bounded by our limitations. Our mind, it functions beyond what we are capable of doing when we allow it to. When we set our mind, it usually gives us success or failures. And a lot of us, when we work, kung magnegosyo man ganita, kung magtrabaho man ganina, we make it sure that we succeed. Kinsay nagtrabaho diri na mo fail, wala man siguro. Diba? When we work, o maningkamot na matag-adlaw, we make it sure that we hit the goal, we hit the target, we attain it, and we don't want to regret that we didn't try. Am I right?
Yes.
Can I hear an amen?
Amen?
But if we are that certain in our physical form, in our physical self, when we do not consider our spiritual life, then we have totally missed the whole package. We live not just in our physical self, but we also live in our spiritual self, in the spiritual realm. And that's why I entitle this sermon, Reality of Living in the Last Days. And so it is very important that we live life outside our routine and the things that we do every day, but having a life confident in Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
A lot of us have been through a lot. May it be in wealth, may it be in your position, may it be in your career. But when you don't have Jesus Christ in your life, that is worthless. I had a big example to that when my father-in-law, Bishop Edgar, 16 years ago, said to me and challenged me, Jonathan, bisag unsa ka taas imo maabot ang imong kumpanya, bisag ma-vice president pa ka diha, kung wala kay kag nada sa kinarian sa Ginoo, baho ka kastaya. That juggled my brain because I always thought that my career was the most important thing. And sometimes it takes someone to wake you up. Until you realize that sometimes the worldly things or the earthly things in life doesn't matter at all.
Yeah.
But your commitment right. In knowing Jesus Christ
yes. As
your Savior.
Yes, yes.
Do you agree with me?
Yes.
Come on, church. We are a full house. Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
Amen. Now I want you to think spiritually. Where we are in our spiritual commitment to Jesus Christ.
Right.
When we look at the internet, we look at the Facebook, we hear reports on the news, do you think there's going to be a better tomorrow? It's very slim, mga igsoon. But we cannot change
right. The
course of nature. But we can change who we are and what we can be capable of doing in these last days. We need to face the reality. The reality that Jesus Christ is coming back. The reality is that how are we in our relationship with Jesus Christ? We come to church on a Sunday morning. We sit down, we listen. But what actually matters in life is that we take actions from the things that comes from the Word of God. And in the scripture that I have just shared to you in Romans chapter 8, verses 5 to 10, let us set our minds not on the physical, but on the spiritual realm. Knowing Christ, having that intimate relationship with Jesus Christ. Because that is the most important thing. You know, we can never share the goodness of God and the love of God if we alone are not secure or not aware that God loves you despite of the sin that we have done. None of us are sinless. None of us. We have our own dirty laundries or skeletons in our closets. But we need to face it. And the reality is, we need repentance.
That's right.
No matter where we are in life right now.
Thank you, Lord.
No matter what we have achieved, we are just dirty rags if we are covered in sin. And God has nothing to do with sin in our lives. They don't mix like oil and water. But the truth is, mga kasuhan, there is Jesus Christ.
Yes.
There is hope. Like when we wake up in the next morning, there is hope. Yes. If you are still breathing today, there is still hope.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Wow.
Yes. When we come into repentance to Jesus Christ, Lord Father, I've heard your word. You are knocking in my heart today. I don't want to miss this opportunity. Not a chance, because life is not a chance. It's a choice.
Amen.
The things that we have achieved in life are because of the choices that we made. Like what Bishop always says to us as a family. If you are born poor, that is not your fault. But when you die poor, it is yours. I can rephrase that. I can rephrase that. If we are born in this world not knowing the truth, but die defending the fool, then we miss the mark.
Yeah. Thank you, Lord.
We are all going to that appointment in whatever stage we are in life. We all have that schedule. The question is, we just don't know when. But before that time comes, take that opportunity to have that special relationship with Jesus Christ in your life. It does not need to be complicated. It does not need to be complicated. Just open your heart. Ask for forgiveness for every stench of sin in our heart. And put it down on the table. Lord, I'm coming to you right now to give this all back to you. Please forgive me. Don't think of the person next to you. Don't think of the person behind or in front of you. Right now, I'm talking to you just one-on-one. Just me and you right now. And I want you to really focus. I'll be going through that verses and nothing else. Focus yourself with Christ. Ask Jesus Christ to forgive everything for what you have done. Then accept, Lord, I've heard your message so many times. I may have hardened my heart, but today, I'm accepting you as my Lord and personal Savior.
Thank you, Lord.
I need to be honest, my soul. We really need to be honest and frank and candid. We need to realize how important Jesus Christ needs to be in our hearts. I may have done this in many organizations that I am involved with. But how much more for us here in church? We need Jesus Christ. The burdens that we face every day are the ways wherein we can be able to see God's miracle hand work in our lives. But we need to first. There's always a prerequisite to be able to receive something. And that is having a relationship with Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
accepting Him as your Lord and personal Savior and asking, Lord, when you call me home, please write my name in the book of life.
Yes.
Because I want to be with you. I want to be with you. I want to enjoy the presence of God and the Holy Spirit and you, Father. Lord, I pray that, Lord, I can live my life prepared for what may come in the future. And once you have that security, you then see the physical realm as just passing by. Magkagubot man rin, want to, you know already, asa ka pa doon. You don't need to carry the burden of the world. But what you need to do is control what you can control in your heart.
Yes.
And have Jesus Christ in your heart. Amen?
Amen.
Make sure life is so safe. Because life is full of choices. And make sure you make the right choice. Amen?
Amen.
Our fleshly desires wreaks discontent, but our spiritual desires completes everything. You know, why katagbawa ng tao? In our physical thing, we find it that there's always something new. Kumbaga, when you have the best phone, the best car for this year, next year it's not. It's already, there's a term for that. Obsolete. It's past its time, or its prime is gone. But when we live our life, focus on Jesus Christ, you are complete. You have attained it. There's no better than that, because Jesus Christ completes you. Amen? And once you have that security of Jesus Christ in our lives, you wake up the next morning praising Him. Even for the fresh air. Even for what little you may have. And you see that life is different having Jesus Christ in your life. Always remember, sin and God never mix. It never mix. So what is important, we clean ourselves every day. Kung unsa ta maligo sa gabi, kay para presko ang atong pagkatong, mausad ang atong pagkatubang sa Dios. Amen? We need to understand that God's love is the beginning of forgiveness and acceptance. You know why we are so uncontented? Why is it that times we feel that we are incomplete? Or we have not attained anything in life? Because we are not secure. We live our life in pretend. We live our life thinking or living in denial. And sad to say, a lot of us wear masks every day, showing people that they are happy. But actually, they're dying inside. They live in fear. They live in shame for past guilt. But life does not need to be like that. There is hope in Jesus Christ. Once you receive the love that comes from above, those things don't matter anymore. You know, sometimes a lot of people may be confused. Why are Christians seeing things not visible to humankind or mankind? How can you live by faith when you have needs? But trust in the Lord. Have that same trust that you have while you're sitting right now. Why are you sitting down? Do you trust the chair that can carry your weight? It's the same trust and faith that you should have, that Jesus Christ will carry your weight.
Yes.
Yes.
Sometimes we don't think of these minor, minute things because we always want the in grande na mga bata. But when we realize how precious God is, how simple and specific God is, we then appreciate life in general. Amen? Wherever you are right now, I ask that you choose life. Choose life in the sense that magwalas ka sa tinapoy. No. Choose to live for God.
Yes.
Human naman ta, siguro we, a lot of us have really are matured. Huwag pa rin yung tiguan ko tanan. Hindi yung mature ta. We have experienced lavish dining. We have experienced the joys in life. But I ask you and I challenge everyone to come to the Lord. Usahin mong good, we have come of age and we still think that we can. Kumbaga, kung tanawin nato, dito magpalupig sa atong karaan na kinaiya. But mga iksoon, it is not about what you have done. But what is important is who you will become. Of what little that we have, but when Jesus Christ is there in you, He will do greater things that you will be amazed. Mga iksoon, sulay ang Ginoo, and He will change your life. Amen? Maybe this is the time for change. Maybe this is the time for spring cleaning ba? Kumbaga maglimpyo. Kumbaga summer na or spring na. Sa laing nasol, it's time to take out the cobwebs. It's now time to check and balance ang atong life. Lord, mo naman dyan yung akong edad, Lord. I am alive because you allowed it to. Lord, I'm asking you, what would you want me to do for you? That question goes to each and every single one of us. What can I do for you? Kahapon, we had a meeting with the presidents of Aguila. And one statement that I will take, he said, let us not work or think what can the fraternity do for us, but what we can contribute to our nation. So that struck my head. It's not about what God can do for us, but what we can do for God. Amen? Sometimes we are a person who just wants. We just expect. Or sometimes we just demand. We want recognition. We want attainment. We want to be pleased. But that's the beginning of pride and ego and failure. But what we can do for others and for the Lord is what is important in life. Mga iksoon, sometimes every Sunday is a reality check. Every pastor shows you the reality of life in these last days. But it is still a choice if you take action upon it. All of us can hear. All of you are hearing me. I don't know if you're understanding. If imo dyo nang ituuhan, everyone can hear, but not all will apply. I hope that you will take action of what comes from the Word of God. And I'll read it back to you. In Romans chapter 8, it says, those who live according to the flesh have their minds set on the flesh desires. Let us not be focused on what we should have, or what we must have, or what we're going to have. Because that will just rust away. You know, I am just so blessed that I have many motorcycles, or have experienced a lot of motorcycles in my life. One time I brought something brand new. 2 to 3 years later, there's rust that comes. No matter how particular I am with my car or my motorcycle, tadadaw, limpyo, tadadaw, nudnud, tadadaw, pasinaw, tadadaw, kulits, mga taya-taya. But yet, in the years to come, naadyo'y taya, naadyo'y abo, naadyo'y grass. It just goes to show what things on earth will fade away. A new house, 2, 3, 5 years, it starts to crack. But my friends, our relationship with Jesus Christ has no end. It does not rust. Pagpangalakon ko. Kung unsa ta kadasig sa Ginoo, unsa ta kakommitted sa Ginoo, in time, it will not break. Because God loves you. His love for you is never ending. His love for you is always fulfilling. His love for you does not consider of who you were or what you have done. But God's love for you creates a better you. And that is eternity. I'm not talking about the physical. I always repeat this to make a joke. Sa una, taas ba yan? Buhok? Bisa kung saan ako, di man ito pamada. Sabi lang, tigawang ta. Gel po ito eh. So kung saan ako, gel. Karoon din ako kagamit o gel. Because time revolves. Kasi kung saan ako, nagwanta ng tubo o gamay. Mawara siya ni Koto. But what is important, my friends, I always make that a joke, that we accept that the reality and focus what is required of us as a Christian. It's not just being a Christian on a soul. Take it into consideration. It's not just because you know or heard about Jesus Christ, but it is about listening, understanding, applying, and doing the will of God through reading His book, the Holy Bible.
Amen.
That is the manual of life. And everything that you need to know to reach that target is in that book. We need to go on our knees and pray. We should be committed. We should be diligent in the responsibilities that the Lord has given each and every one of us. Because there will not be any rust. It will not break. It will not be rotten. Because God is permanent.
Hallelujah.
He is that solid rock, the refuge. The refuge. And as I come to an end, mga Iksuon, it's all about the mindset that we should have. It's all about the mindset, our focus in Jesus Christ. Choose life, because it's all about choices. And use today as an assurance that Jesus Christ is knocking in your door. As I end, mga Iksuon, let us find freedom in Jesus Christ. And that's how we live our life in these last days. Enjoying the freedom that the Lord has promised you and me. Now, Satan tries to limit our prayer because he knows our praying will limit him. Yawa, naningkamot sa paglimitar sa atong pag-ampo, kay kabalo siya ang atong pag-ampo o limitar niya. So, dili na ito natugutan na ang yawa mo daw.
Yes.
Ang Ginoo daw.
Amen.
Let us increase our meditation and prayer. Let us increase our faith. Na ay balanse. Balanse sa pagtrabaho sa atong lawas no. Pero ang ultimate goal in life is to be a vessel, an instrument of God in our last days. Despite the fact that the world is going, we're not getting any better, but we are getting better with God. Amen?
Yes.
Amen.
Now as I end, I just want to emphasize, life depends on the decisions you make today and for the years to come. Live for what counts, and that is eternity. In Romans 15, verse 13, may the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in Him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. Stand. Let us bow our heads and close our eyes. Father God in heaven, we come to you this morning. We praise you, dear God, because you are moving in our presence. Thank you, Lord, for touching our hearts. Thank you, Lord, for being there in times of need. Thank you, Lord, for carrying me in this time of despair. Lord, a lot of my brothers and sisters have lost a lot of things. They are going through relationship struggles. They are going through heart issues. They are bearing these health issues, Lord God. Lord, I pray, Lord, for deliverance to everyone that seeks it today. Lord, for those who desire you in their life, Lord, I pray that they will humble down and open their heart and repent in your presence, that you may live in their heart as their personal Lord and personal Savior. Father, I pray for relationship to be mended. I pray, Lord, for life for everyone that hears right now. Lord, Father, I pray for the struggles of many, that, Lord, that you will reign supreme. Father, I pray for those who are lost, that they will be found. Lord God, you know our issues, you know our desire, you know our problems, you know our struggles. But Lord, we seek your face and we hold on to you. Lord, in these last days, the reality may be slim, but Father, your love, your Son, Jesus Christ, is the solid rock foundation that I cling to. Father, I pray that, Lord, that you will bless everyone that is here right now. Give them life. Give them hope. Give them the courage to endure in these last days. Father, we magnify your name because you alone are worthy of all praises and adoration. Bless your people, Father. As we go home today, may your blessing go with us. And not just to us, but to the families and friends that we are associated with. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. We give back all the honor and glory to you, Jesus Christ. Amen and amen.